Hey guys, this is Cameron. I make instructional scooter videos about different scooters. In this video, you will learn how to do a handle bleed on your zoom brakes on your Apollo Pro. Use your T15 torx to remove the brake handle filler screw, and then you're going to use your $10 kit you got from Alibaba or AliExpress, and you need to figure out which one of the threads are the same as that little plug. I just touched the threads together on these and you can see that they will interlock, and so you know it's the same type of thread. So thread in that little adapter. Locate the little cup in your kit. Locate your mineral oil that you got from IKEA called Sklurgen or something like that. Just fill in maybe like a half an inch into the cup. That's all you need. Cap that bottle so you don't have a big old mess when you spill it on your workbench. Take out the little plug so that the mineral oil will go down into your brake handle. I'm spinning my tire to check whether or not the brakes work. Both the front and rear brakes got real soft on this scooter shortly after I got it with about 500 miles on it. So they're coming back right now. What I'm doing is I'm tilting the scooter from one side to the other side so that any bubbles trapped in that brake handle can come out the top. Just trying it over and over with the motor running, and the simple handle bleed for maybe 1 to 2 minutes straight fixed it. Now I am blocking off the flow of that mineral oil. I'm removing that T15 security torx screw from the right side brake handle so that I can just directly take that filler from the left side handle and put it right into the right side handle. And then I will put my T15 security torx screw back into the left side handle as soon as I can to keep contamination out of there. Don't use a drill to put these back in. I've been using drills for over 40 years, so I can't, but I don't recommend you do it. Remove that plug so that the mineral oil can flow into the brake handle. Pump the brakes. In this one, I do notice that some dark colored oil swirled up into my cup, which is a good sign. I did not notice any bubbles come out. I'm kicking the wheel with my foot to check whether the brakes work or not. I'm tilting it from one side to the other to release any trapped bubbles in the brake system. And I'm trying it by kicking my front tire with my foot to see if the brakes actually work. Now I'm gonna get my handles set up correctly. I took off my display. I'm gonna put it back where it should be. This is how you get your brake handle to sit closer or further from your handle. You just tighten and loosen an Allen wrench in the handle there. It's really best to get your brake system closed and also protect the stuff you use to work on it. So get rid of that, clean it, put it in plastic bags because you don't want any contamination going into your brake lines. Here I'm reinstalling that T15 torx screw that closes off the brake system. As you can see, I wipe up quite a bit during this process. The last thing you want is a bunch of oil all over your scooter. I am pouring the excess contaminated oil into a water bottle to throw away that way so it doesn't make a mess someplace. What you need to do is you need to have your brake handle, your key switch, and your display loose in order to align them correctly. Also, they can get in the way of each other, so you might find that your brake handle or your display, once those are tight, you cannot tighten down your key switch. So you may have to tighten down your key switch first and then tighten the other two last. Just really depends on the position that you prefer. I like mine low. Low is the best, but then I'm tall, I have long arms, I have long fingers, so low works for me for brake handles, throttles, and stuff like that. Try to tighten those brake handle screws evenly so you don't have like the top one tightened all the way and then a big gap in the bottom one. You want to have everything symmetrical and equal so that the forces are equal and doesn't want to break. The best way to put on your grips is just put some water inside of the hand grip, put water on your handlebars, and slide them right on. Don't tighten everything down until your grip is on because that shows you your spacing. When you tighten these displays, you'll notice that there are four screws on the display, whether it's this one, the QSS4, or it's a Mini Motors Eye display, if you're talking about a Dualtron or a Cabo. Two of them hold the display on. Those ones, the two closest to the display, don't touch those. You don't need to. They just attach the display to the mount. Since those mounts are usually plastic, you just don't want to over-tighten the two that keep it tight on your handlebars. So just use your Allen wrench in the long position so you don't get a lot of torque on it. All right, that fixed it. Take a moment to like, comment, subscribe. Catch you later, guys. This is Cameron. Well, I bet you didn't know all of the different names of this scooter, which is a Titan T10DDM. It's also called a 010X, Macury Speedual Zero, Unicool T10DDM, Unicool F8-1, Unicool Swift, Varla Eagle 1, Evolv Pro, Turbowheel Lightning, Bexly 10X, Techlife X7S, Monopattino T10, Anttech T10DDM, Dualbots G7, Quickvolt 10X, Freeway Monopattino Electrico 10X and X-Tron 10X.